This has worked pretty damn well for the stuff that was directly in contact with the liquid. I thought I purchased a gallon. I purchased a quart. So I didn't quite have enough to cover it. They said cover everything in wet rags, you know, soaked in the evaporust. And it will penetrate, or it'll stay on the surface, keep it in a box so it doesn't evaporate. It's done a pretty damn good job. It's been in here for about 12 hours. I wish I had more of it to soak more of it. Maybe I'll rotate everything, or I don't know. I'm gonna wire wheel this. I think that's what I'm gonna do. Well, first rinse it, and then wire wheel it. I did have rubber gloves at one point. Not sure what happened to them. That was chemicals. Yeah, you can see a clear line. I don't know if you can see it, but where it was submerged, this bottom half, the rust is just flaking off nicely. Top half, not so much. I mean, it was draped with the wet rags, but they didn't have complete contact. I think I'll call this phase one of rust removal. I'll keep these rags. Buy some more evaporust if the wire wheel doesn't do enough here. All right, so I may as well try and start cleaning up the worst one. If I can get the worst one clean, then bodes well for the others. So I've just dry fit everything and given everything just a coat of WD-40. I don't want it flash rusting while I'm sitting around talking to you. I spent about an hour wire wheeling it, and it's looking really good. There's a couple more spots I want to get in. I may actually try fixing up the broken nozzle in my blast cabinet. That was a Harbor Freight nozzle, and it died after doing this front half. You can see the moving jaw has come out a lot nicer than the back half. I think it's both ends are completely serviceable. I could wash it, prime it, and paint it right now, but might try sandblasting again. Honestly, I think I'm just procrastinating from the next task, which is really doing some screw extraction. I've got these broken screws in here. I don't generally have a lot of success with screw extraction, but I'll give it a go. Worst case scenario, I'll drill and tap further next size up, and that'll do. But yeah, we're getting real close to this thing being done. The jaws close and open. Well, jaws close and open. And it's getting cleaned up. So I'm pretty happy with progress. Might come in and take some photos and give you some close-up before and after shots. Thank you. cleaning up everything was a lot of fun. I'll continue working on that, but I'm just delaying the inevitable, which is really working on the situation with these three screw holes. The first one is clear all the way through. No screw in there, that's great. The second one, the screw is stuck in, about 1/8 of an inch has been removed, but the rest of it's stuck back all the way there. The third one, the head of the screw is still here. You can see where I've drilled it out a little bit last year, and I tried using the screw extractor to remove it, and I didn't have much luck. I can't find that small screw extractor. I can only find this big one. I don't know if it's going to get any purchase. I'll give it a go on these two, but I think my best bet is probably to re-drill and tap them. Now, I have my thread gauge here. I checked this bolt here. It looks like it's a 1032. So I grabbed 1032 from my parts drawer, and that fits in great, which is nice. So it's nice to know that that's what that is. If I do have to re-tap these and make them larger, that's going to be pretty large, going up to like a 12, but it is what it is. All right, I'm going to put this on a drill and see if we can extract these two. So I was able to clear out these two holes pretty easily, but I tried using a drill bit to make myself some more room to get purchase either with the screw extractor or to possibly just break through with the tap. Unfortunately, my drill bit snapped inside the hole. And I'm going to try and get it out. There's just like 3/16, no, whatever, 1/4 inch of drill bit in there, but I got it out, so happy. Well, I managed to drill through the screw. That was pretty easy. Second time, it's a charm. Hopefully I haven't shouted up the threads too much and I can get it to clean up with a tap. I'm just gonna say it now because that'll then stop it from actually happening. I think that's how it works anyway. I don't want to break this tap. Thank you. That was not as bad as I was worrying about. I've got all three screw holes cleaned out. I've driven two screws in. I could put the third one in now. These screws aren't quite the right match. They're 1032, but the heads look a little weird. Maybe I can find some brass ones and shave them down a little bit so they just look a little visually better here. But the next thing I think to do is, well, clean up the jaws. So I tried removing the jaws. I cleaned out the slots, these slot head screws. These are the cleaner of the two. See, I've got a wrench on this screwdriver using as a cheater. But I cleaned these two out and got plenty of good depth of insertion, but it would cam out and it would just tear up the soft screw heads. I think they're in there pretty good. I was hoping to maybe take these jaws out and replace them with some copper soft jaws, but you know, I think I'm going to leave them as is. I'm going to get back to cleaning this guy and then get ready for paint.